Dung Beatles, Castlewellan and Factor's longest serving band. Coming to you. The envy of many.
I even remember, you know, growing up hearing Beatles songs. All their songs are timeless.
They built the structure for rock and roll.
On the surface, all was well, but behind the scenes, jealousy and infighting was pushing the band to breaking point. Join us for Dung Beatles, Behind the Music.
The first year went fine, for so it did. But to be honest, after that, the cracks started to appear. We started to get far more successful, and the weight of expectation and the competition just... it really started to get us. People were expecting us to deliver night after night after night. And you could just see in the second year that things just weren't all as they appeared.
To be perfectly honest, I always felt like a bit of an outsider. In a group of three cousins, all a bit younger than me, with the benefit of hindsight, it probably wasn't a good idea. Like, Tintin's a good lad, but them are two clowns, holy fuck. Not for me.
Fuck with Tintin and stupid fucking ideas.
Jackie fits the yuppie bastard.
I just think it's because he's a wee bit older than us.
Nah, he's just a bally prick.
Hey boy!
Oh, sorry.
And another thing. We formed to represent the seconds.
Huh.
I don't ever remember Garth Young playing seconds.
No, never. Never.
What the fuck's Tintin all about anyway? Only fucking hang everyone in the town. Is he a F-Factor?
In the second year, the band put their differences aside, but it wasn't long until old tensions started to rear their heads.
We had just put in a great performance, but behind the scenes, it was all going off.
Fucking brutal.
Absolutely shocking.
Okay. Fucking hell. Fuck off, Tintin, with the hanging your brown shoes and your fucking night pants bottom.
He has a point. Yeah, okay.
Fuck
the
fuck.
You're telling
him
every time.
No,
we're not. It's not all the day. Fuck off. Cuts. I'll kill you, you bastard.
I thought I'd put in a great performance. Tell that ginger bastard Tintin started going off on one.
Oh, we fucked up that time.
Absolutely woeful.
Okay, so my timing was a wee bit off. But to be honest, I think them all three were a wee bit quick.
After that, I had enough.
Dacky quit. Good riddance if you ask me.
Fucking Tintin dropped Peggy back into the fan. Not that he was any use anyway. Fucking dropped the microphone and all costs us a fucking fan.
Listen to teetotaler Ogie passing judgment of me drinking. Think you get a life out of it.
Once again, the band quit, but under pressure from Castlewellan Club, they reformed, winning the competition with the stirring performance of Tina Turner's Proud Mary.
The F Factor definitely needs them.
The F Factor needs them? Seriously?
It's not just the F Factor that needs them. The club needs them.
Fuck the club. What have they done for me?
I actually don't know how to do it, but... see, at the rehearsals, talking about an atmosphere. When they came to the woods on a few occasions, it was madness.
It's hard to believe all that Darrell's going on behind the scenes. Imagine how good it would be if they actually all got on with each other.
Oh,
after the Vayner title, not even sure if it anymore.
Winning the F Factor and the pressure it brings, I mean, it destroys teams. Look at the Heart of Hearts. One went down under, one went to Eastern Europe, one went down the fucking road to Bransford.
This is definitely the last year.